Beautiful picture of a chest in a magazine, and I showed it to Daddy, and I said, isn't this pretty? He said, yeah, you like that? I said, yeah, I love that. So lo and behold, 3 months later, maybe it was Christmas or some occasion, Daddy had built it for me out of solid oak, and I was so touched. It was so beautiful. And he would go every day to somebody's house who had like a wood shop in their garage, and he would borrow their tools and made this beautiful, what I think is absolutely beautiful, chest for me. He lined it with cedar and everything. So that was probably about 41 years ago. Wow. Anyway, and then when we got engaged and people gave us gifts, I put it in there. And when we got married, people gave us gifts and I put those in there. And it never had a finishing coat on it, though. It was just a raw wood hope chest. We moved it from our apartment upstairs to our first little bungalow house, and it was there, and it held treasures and things. And then we moved it to this house 30 years ago, and in all those years, it still was never finished. So I think it's about 3 years ago, I had somebody come and put the final finishing touches, which is really just sanding and staining it, and now it's all finished and full of sweaters and things that we don't want the moths to eat. It just seemed like such a lovely and romantic notion that you wanted one too, because you're a romantic. I thought it was precious, just like so many things that you do that are different and quirky and totally you. You know, a hope chest can be about lots of different things. It doesn't have to just be about marriage and stuff. It's about, you know, a home you'll make for yourself one day.
We in America are immigrants, or the children of immigrants, or the children of the children of immigrants.
I like it here. that building has been there with the sky above it for 100 years. Just like that, with how many families passing through.
They were adorable. I remember thinking that Grandpa looked like Geppetto. And Grandma, I have a picture of her one really snowy, snowy day. Daddy and I were shoveling like 3 feet of snow. And I have a picture of her opening the front door and handing out a little something for us to eat that she had just made, because everything she made was homemade. I loved them right away. Grandpa is a big jokester like Daddy is. He played the rubber walnut trick on me and it worked. He likes to watch, he called them his stories. He watched soap operas. He said, I have to watch my story now. If he didn't like something, like, he didn't like to go out to eat. He only wanted Grandma to cook. But we took him to Mohonk Mountain House, and Grandpa, he didn't like the food. And he would take a bite and he would throw it down on his plate, say, I can't eat that. And then he would eat the whole thing. And if you told Grandma a story about something that made you happy, she was so happy. I remember we came home from a camping trip and we had a lot of funny stories to tell. And she was sitting there giggling like a little kid. And it made me feel so good that she really was listening and was just so happy that we had so much fun. Like, she almost was crying. She was so happy. Peas in the pot. They wouldn't have wanted to miss knowing you, honey. Not in a million years.
They'd be so proud of every little thing you did.
Oh my gosh. And all your embroidery and all your projects and all your creativity, Grandma would have gone crazy. She would have said, look at all that love. Right?
Treasure.
Whenever we made something, she'd always say, look at all that love.
That's a treasure.
That's a treasure. That's what she would say.
I don't think I expected you to grow up in any particular way. You know, I followed Grandma and Grandpa's child raising strategy. Just love the crap out of them, and they'll be fine. I think I know what time you're gonna like. I think I would like at late at night or early in the morning when nobody's around. Quiet and beautiful. You're going to see the things that, you know, you wouldn't see. And crowds of people. All kinds of beautiful things. And maybe bad things. But they can be beautiful too.
Everyone's eye. You have such a charming manner, sweet and shy. Little old bonnet set in place, and a smile on your face. You're a perfect picture in your lavender and lace. A little bit of business here, little bit of business there. Bet that you've been window shopping all around the square.